Welcome to Zabok Airfield, Gubaševo, Croatia. My first competition in season 2019. We are waiting for the flyoff to start and some pilots are testing the air. You can see some clouds in the sky. We had very interesting spring weather. Storms were both days about 30 kilometers to the west of us, and we got the changing winds and changing conditions here as a result. Yesterday we even got a short microburst that broke lots of models, and the group that was flying at that time, I think three pilots lost their models over that hill. Two of them were later found. But still, it was an unpleasant event. If you are in the air and the microburst hits you, good luck. So as you can see, I'm at a very good vantage point. They have a small tower-like structure here, and this gives me the opportunity to show you the surroundings from a better angle than usual. You see there are lots of bushes and trees all around the runway. This makes it for a very dynamic environment for thermals to develop, especially when there's a bit of a wind blowing. Right now we have wind from northeast, that's currently in my left back, which means all the lift is concentrated towards the west, towards this hill here behind me. Now coming into view, and today all of the flights were done in this direction. I found it interesting that you didn't really have to go far in the distance above the hill to get the lift. The wave generated by this wind was already here at the camp, so it wasn't necessary to carry yourself downwind too much, which made it for a very easy flying. No worries about being able to return or not. Wind speed currently, I would say, is, I don't know, 3 to 6 meters per second varying, and the direction is, as you can see, perpendicular to the runway. It's also perpendicular to the starting lines. It blows just across the corridor. So maybe if I can try to show the tape down here. So it's slightly diagonal, slightly at an angle, but mostly aligned with the corridor. So this will make for challenging landings with the crosswind, and I'm sure it will have some interesting shots. Now let's wait. Okay, first start. Ariane very low, very slow. Still below my height. Let's see how that works out. Whoa. Seconds have passed. And that's where he is. he immediately moved to a better vantage point to actually see what his model is doing. There's actually a TV crew that just arrived. Very nice. I would say what he's doing now is slope soaring on those trees. I hear a buzzard calling in that direction, which tells me something's happening over there. Maybe they're just afraid of the multitude of planes that suddenly appeared in their sky. This looks like a stressful way to spend 15 minutes in the air, but it kinda looks like it might be possible. The rest of the planes are already 300 meters plus over the hill. They all chose the safe option, so they really just need to wait for the time to pass. But let's see how the master will do it. Very precise flying, always at the minimum speed, no stalls or aggressive rudder movements. Looks like he got something now. he now carried himself with the wind and gained lots of height as a result. And from that height I think he's good, he'll make this flight. No problem whatsoever. So the rest of the planes are even farther away than he is. Don't know if you can see any. Nothing interesting to see here, I guess. Just wait for them to return. We have now passed the 2 minutes to go mark. Pilots look rather boring, waiting for their planes to return. Not much to do but wait, I guess. Yeah, they have now pure 90 degrees crosswind. So the landings will be interesting. That signal was 1 minute to go. Seconds to go and I only see one plane because majority will be coming from this direction. Landing in last second, very nice. And a perfect landing. I expect Ariane will be very hard to beat at Trnava World Championship. Pilots are now ready for the second start. And sun is peeking through the clouds every now and then I feel a bit of heat, which means thermals will be even better. Look at that. So before noon we've seen couple of starts like this. Even yesterday we've seen starts from like 15 meters below 20 for sure. But I wasn't expecting to see them in the flyoffs. Looks reckless, but guys know what they're doing. So now he's not the only one low, there are at least two more. And things are getting interesting. Looks like a bit to the south, there's good air already. Even in here, no problem at all. Yeah, the wind is now picking up, which I guess means some of these guys will be blown up. Whoa, there was a midair. Didn't hear it, didn't see it. One plane with a broken wing went into the bush. Very narrow circling now. Looks like no problem. So there's now a bird that joined the crowd. No doubt that it got curious about what's happening in the air. So it seems like another wait for the planes to return, because they are now so far in the distance that I'm not sure you can see them. Even the spectators don't look too impressed observing the flight, because the planes are so far away. Arjan is slowly returning to his landing point. That signal was 5 minutes until the end of flight. And as you can probably see, sun is now shining. It's now less than a minute till the end of flight, and I see planes returning. Thirty seconds. Very nice. Now let's wait for a decision on a reflight for that guy who went down. Maybe we will have 4 flights instead of 3. Looks like there won't be any refly. And this is now the 3rd flight. Hard to decide whom to follow, because now everyone is really, really low. Look at that. But at least Arjan got 2 good flights, so he can now afford maybe 10 meters more or so. So I saw him overflying the tower, so he's not as low as before. Another broken tail. Wow. I saw this one with half of the wee tail cut or broken. Didn't see what happened. It looks like just a bit of a too fast landing. So from the group here, there are 2 interesting planes to follow. Thank you. So that one will make it, but there's another one a bit more in trouble, I would say. You see the wing peeking just there behind the trees, now over that roof. Yeah, looks like he will make it as well. But I wouldn't call this in any way a relaxing flying. Looks pretty stressful to me. Definitely not my kind of fun. Looks like he's out now. Or maybe not. No, he decided to go back again. At least get to that meadow. He doesn't have enough. Now he ended in the tree. Yeah. If he had turned right, he could have landed. In the meantime, the other planes are again very high. 300 meter plus. Nothing else to do but wait until they return. Looks like one plane was found. And looks properly broken fuselage. And just slight damage to the wings. Now less than a minute for the until the finish of the third flight. Wind has picked up considerably, luckily more in the direction of landing. So pilots now have to come in at a steeper angle, carrying more energy to be actually be able to reach the landing points. And they did it.
We don't have a reply. flight already started.
Okay, I just heard there will be a refly now, so we will have four flights after all. This is now a refly of the third flight, which means we will see some even more riskier attempts. What's that? Little bit of motor and a full butterfly. Yeah. It again looks like that bush over there is very tempting to some people. But this time it looks like they're high enough to make it across it or over it. So to my right, there's still interesting things happening. I'm not sure if that will be enough. This was a good decision. At least there's a safe landing zone available in case it is needed. Yeah, looks like he will make it. So as I said before, he's one of the best pilots currently flying this category. And if anyone asks me on whom to place a bet for the world championship, it would be him. That was 1 minute until the end of last flight of today and for this competition. And the wind is again in a favorable direction, but gaining in strength, so landing won't be exactly trivial. Some good energy management will be required from the pilots. Yeah. This is how some of them do it. Just hanging there in the air, waiting for the right time to aim for the landing point. And just one short, very good.
Once again, thank you for coming, and I hope that we will see each other on this field next year. We had some problems with the software, so the complete results will be published on the internet later afternoon. So let's start. We had only one junior from Slovenia, David Gergic Strauss. He had the first place. You know, is he here or still looking for a model?
Looking for a model.
Can someone else pick his trophy from Slovenia? Jure?
Ne. Može, Primoš, boš ti uzeo.
Primoš. Za juniora.
Malo za.
Evo. Junior, congratulations. So, fly-off pilots, let's start with the 9th place, Francis Nicola, 984 points. 8th place, from Austria, Gerhard Nössing, 1,966 points. 7th place, Damir Kosir, 2,916 points. 6th place, Primoš Rižner from Slovenia, 2,946. 5th place, Sebastian Manhart from Germany, 2,959 points. 4th place, also from Germany, Julian Benz, 2,971 points. Third place, from Czech Republic, Ludek Novotny. 2nd place, from Austria, Hermann Haas,
2,000.
And the winner with the full house, as usual, from Croatia, Arjan Kuceljov. Trophy from contest Europe 2019. Congratulations once again.